In our previous class, I have explained how to handle different types of data for doing cluster analysis. I have started some theory, if there is a mixed data type, how to handle that kind of data. The agenda for today's lecture is how to find the dissimilarity matrix for mixed type variables, and we will do Python demo for computing different types of distances, which I have explained theory in my previous lectures. And also, I will tell you Python demo for computing distance matrix for interval scale data. Now, let us take an example. This is a mixed type data set. So, consider the data given in the following table and compute a dissimilarity matrix for the object of the table. Now, we will consider all of the variables which are different types. So, there are three type of data set, one is categorical, ordinal and ratio scaled. If this kind of mixed data type is there, how to use this kind of data set for finding dissimilarity matrix and giving as an input for the cluster analysis. The procedures we followed for the test 1, which is categorical data, and the test 2, which is ordinal data, are the same as outlined above for processing variables of mixed type. So, what you have done, if it is a categorical variable type, we have used this p minus m divided by p. So, where the p is number of variables, where m is number of matches, that we have discussed in our previous class. If it is ordinal data, we have to standardize into 0 to 1 by using this formula, z equal to if equal to rif, that is the current rank minus 1 divided by maximum rank minus 1. So, this after converting into 0 to 1 scale, then we can use our simple Euclidean method for finding the dissimilarity matrix. For interval scaled variable, so dif for f equal to xif minus xjf modulus divided by maximum value of hxf minus minimum value of hxf. First, normalizing the interval scaled data. First, however, we need to complete some work for test 3, which is ratio scaled. We have already applied a logarithmic transformation to its values. Based on the transformation values, we got 2.65, 1.34, 2.21 and 3.08 obtained for the objects 1 to 4 respectively. We let a maximum value of hx is from this among these values. The maximum value is 3.08 and the minimum value is 1.34. We then normalize the value in the dissimilarity matrix obtained in the example and solve for ratio data by dividing each one by this difference, that is 3.08 minus 1.34, that is 1.74. This result in the following dissimilarity matrix for test 3. So, what happened there? There was a object identifier was there. There was a ratio scale was there. I am calling it as x. So, we have taken log of that value 2.65, 1.34, 2.21. So, we have to standardize this one. For that purpose, for example, 1 and 2, we use this formula, that is this formula to standardize. So, here 2.65 this value minus this value divided by the maximum value and minus minimum value. So, when you divide this, this is a 0.75. So, 2 comma 1, this was the distance. Similarly, if you want to know 4 comma 1, so 4 comma 1, so the difference is 2.65 minus 3.08, so whole divided by this value, that is 1.74, it will give you this value. The same way the standardization is done for all the cells. Now, let us consider dissimilarity matrices for all three variables. What are the three variables? One is categorical, ordinal and ratio data. So, we can now use the dissimilarity matrices for the three variables in our computation of equation. So, our dif for f equal to xif minus xjf divided by max h xhf minus minimum h xhf. For example, we got between d to 1. So, this is the location 2 comma 1. I will explain how we got 0.92. So, how we got this one is, so there are three variables here. For dissimilarity matrix it is 1, for categorical variable, for ordinal variable for 2 comma 1 position is 1, for a ratio data it is a 0.75. So, we will find out the weighted mean. So, weight is, we are giving equal weight for all kind of data set. So, 1 into 1 plus 1 into 1 plus 1 into 75. So, total sum of weight is 3. So, 0.92, that is how we got this value, right. Similarly, each element you can do that one. For example, here 1 into 1 plus 1 into 0.5 plus 1 into 0.25 divided by 3. So, we will get this value. So, this matrix is a resulting dissimilarity matrix obtained for data described by the 3 variables for the mixer type. So, this dissimilarity matrix is given as an input for doing the cluster analysis. So, what happened? This is a combined matrix, combined dissimilarity matrix for all 3 kind of variables. What are that variables? It is for categorical, ordinal and ratio data. If you go back and look at the table of the given data, we can intuitively guess that the object 1 and 4 are most similar based on their values of test 1 and test 2. You see that, because you see, look at this one, this is 0, this is 0, this is 0.25. In the given matrix, for example, for say for categorical data it is 0, for ordinal data it is 0. It look like the position of 4, 1 for both the variables, it seems to be very similar. But what is happening here in the third, where it is ratio data, it is 0.25. But when you find the average of 3, weighted average, by looking at the dissimilarity matrix for categorical and ordinal, look at the position of 4, 1. So, this seems to be very similar because it is close to 0. But what is happening, the 0.25, it is not very close to 0. So, this can be verified by, when you look at this one. So, among the all the data set in the combined, the resulting dissimilarity matrix, the value of 0.08 is very similar. So, the position of 4, 1 is very similar to each other. That is the point. This is confirmed by the dissimilarity matrix, where 4, 1 is the lowest value for any pair of objects. Similarly, the matrix indicates that the object 2, 4 are the least similar. When you look at this, 2, 4. So, the highest value is 1. When you go there, here also 2, 4, here also it is 1, here also 1, here also 1. So, in the resulting dissimilarity matrix also, this seems to be 1. So, highly dissimilar. Now, we will go to the distance measurement using Python. In my previous class, I have explained how to find out Euclidean distance, Manhattan's distance, Minkowski distance. So, this is an example for Euclidean distance. The formula for finding Euclidean distance is xi 1 minus xj 1 whole square plus xi 2 minus xj 2 whole square plus xi p minus xj p whole square. If there are only 2 variable, the distance formula is xi 1 minus xj 1 whole square plus xi 2 minus xj 2 whole square square root. But how to use Python command? I brought the screenshot of that. For that, import scipy. From scipy.spatial, import distance. So, how to find the Euclidean distance? So, import numpy as np. So, a and b, there are two, a is one point where 1, 2, 3, the b is another point 4, 5, 6. If you want to know the distance, Euclidean distance between a comma b, so we have to write dst equal to distance dot Euclidean a comma b. So, when you type dst, so this is the our Euclidean distance between point a and b. The next, the distance is Minkowski distance. So, the Minkowski distance is the combination of both Manhattan distance and Euclidean distance. So, dij equal to xi 1 minus xj 1 to the power p plus xi 2 minus xj to the power p and so on plus xi n minus xj n to the power p whole to the power 1 by p. So, what is happening? This is small p. If the p equal to 1, then it is a Manhattan distance. If the p equal to 2, it is an Euclidean distance. Let us see how to find out this Minkowski distance using Python. So, I have taken 2 points, Minkowski distance, let us see 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. So, the comma 1, this represents that we are finding Manhattan's distance. So, when you enter this, the Manhattan distance is 2. So, the same data set, if you type 2 here, we will get Euclidean distance, because the p equal to 2, we will get a formula for Euclidean distance, that is 1.14. So, this was our another example, just to verifying this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 2. So, this will represent our Euclidean distance. Suppose if you take 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6, because the p value can be 3 also. If it is 3, the Minkowski distance is 4.32. This formula distance dot Minkowski 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 2, this data previously we have used the distance between by using this formula distance dot equivalent distance a, b, we got 5.19. So, by using Minkowski formula also, the Minkowski formula, the same data set if you type 2, you will get the same answer. So, the distance dot Minkowski between the two points 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6, 3, where the p equal to 3. So, this is our Minkowski distance. Now, let me explain how to find out dissimilarity matrix. So, for that you have to import pandas spd from scipy dot spatial import distance underscore matrix. So, there are 1, 2, there are 3 points 1, 4, 2, 5, 3, 6. So, there are 2 column a, b. So, pd dot data from data, columns equal to this one, you will get this kind of output. So, if you want to know the distance between a, b, so there are identifier name is 0, 1 and 2, there are 2 variables a and b. So, if you want to know the distance matrix between different identifiers 0, 0 is 1, 1, 0 is 1.41, 2, 0 is 2.84 by using this command distance underscore matrix df dot values and df dot values. Now, distance matrix calculation for interval scaled variables. For example, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There is a 8 persons. We can say object identifier. Take 8 people. The weight is given in kilograms and the height is given in centimeters. So, n equal to 8. So, p equal to 2. Now, how to find out the distance matrix? So, I have taken the data 15, 95. 49, 156 and so on. So, there is a labels A, B, C, D, E, F, of G, H. So, the data from is, so weight and height. So, we got this table. So, weight and height is there, there is a different object identifier. Suppose, if you want to know the distance matrix, so for that P D dot data from distance underscore matrix, you take these values. So, we are getting the distance matrix between A and A 0, B and A. So, you see that the diagonal value 0 because it is a replica of. So, this is a mirror image because the distance between F and F is 0, G and G 0 is a 0. So, what is happening between A and B and A, it is 69.83, A and B also 69.83, this is a mirror value. We will round into 1 decimal. So, by using matrix distance underscore matrix dot round decimal equal to 1. So, out equal to none. So, we got this matrix. This will run with help of Python. Now, let us see how to use Python to find the distance between points. So, import scipy from scipy dot spatial import distance. I have run that one. Now, let us know how to find out equivalent distance. So, import numpy as np, there are 2 point a comma b, the position of point a is 1, 2, 3, the position of point b is 4, 5, 6. If you want to know the distance, so dst equal to distance dot Euclidean, then if you want to know the what is the distance, so we let us display distance. So, distance is 5.19, that is the between point a and b, the Euclidean distance is 5.19. Now, let us know how to find out the Minkowski distance. For that, the Minkowski distance is calculated by using this function distance dot Minkowski. This is position of point A and position of point B. Then if you use 1, you will get a Manhattan distance. So, this is Manhattan distance. Instead of 1, if you use 2, you will get here. Instead of 1, if you get 2, you will get a Euclidean distance. This is 1.41. We already got 5.19 as a Euclidean distance. Even the Minkowski function, you can verify that answer. What happened here? I have given distance dot Minkowski. I have taken the same point, that is 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6. This one, I used 2. So, number 2 is used 2. get the Euclidean distance. Number 1 is used to get Manhattan distance. So, we got to see that this is also 5.19 when in the function Minkowski if I use p. Otherwise, by using distance dot Euclidean function itself, we got 5.19. So, both are same. Now, I will explain how to find out the dissimilarity or distance matrix. Import pandas as pd from scipy dot spatial import distance underscore matrix. The data equal to 1, 4, 2, 5, 3, 6. So, there are 3 data set for 2 variables. If I want to know the distance between A and B, now we have 3 data set for 2 variables. If I want to know the distance matrix, so pd dot data frame in bracket distance underscore matrix df dot values comma df dot values. So, we will get this is distance matrix. So, there are 2 variables and 3 data set. So, this the distance matrix between 0 and 0 is 0, between 1 and 0 is 1.41, between 2 and 0 is 2.82. Now, we will go for a distance calculation. For that, import pandas as pd, import numpy as np, I have run it. So, the data matrix is given like this. So, there are 2 variables, there are 8 persons A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Suppose if you want to know the distance matrix, so pd dot data frame distance underscore matrix, you follow this command, the distance matrix is this one, right? Between A and A 0, between B and A 69.83, between C and A it is 2.00. So, if you want to have 1 decimal, if you with the rounding of 1 decimal, we got this distance matrix. So, this distance matrix is given as an input for cluster analysis. In this lecture, I have explained how to find out the dissimilarity matrix for mixed type of variables. What is the meaning of mixed type of variables? When we go for a cluster analysis, the data set may be combination of ordinal, interval and ratio data. When these 3 types of data come together, how to find out the dissimilarity matrix, that I have explained. Then by using Python, I have explained how to find out the distance. So, I have explained how to find out the Euclidean distance, then I have explained how to find out the Manhattan distance, and then I have explained how to find the Minkowski distance. At the end, I have explained with the help of Python how to find out the distance matrix for the interval scaled data, because that distance matrix can be used as an input for our cluster analysis. Thank you.